show has baseball for you under the lights at Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Tonight, it's an NL Eastern Division showdown between the Miami Marlins and the Philadelphia Phillies. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Aaron Nola will be on the bump for game two of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, one of the strengths of this guy is handling right-handed hitters. Right-handers coming into this game are hitting under 250 against this guy, so he's doing a lot of things right when the right-hander steps
into
the batter's box.
For Miami.
Ready now for the Marlins, John Birdie. And the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. First pitch of the AB on its way. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing in one. These Phillies, as they enter play here tonight, fellas, they're definitely in a nice stretch as they've won six of their last seven ball games.
Yeah, Maddie, this place is buzzing right now. This team won the opener of the series yesterday, and they're looking to step on this team's throat and take the first two games of the series.
1-1 to the Marlins leadoff hitter. Swing and a weak little line drive over the first. But an easy play there at first as that becomes the first out of the inning. With that, he'll go with the batting order for the Marlins. Mark, what's your take on him against one of the best starters in the game?
Well, Matt, going into this, looking at both lineups, they're both hot right now and they can both swing the bats. We probably got a slugfest on our hands. What pitcher's going to make the big pitch? A big spot, execute something to get his team off the field. Otherwise, probably a team with the last at bats could win this one.
Corey Dickerson is next as he finds himself behind 0-1. Bases are empty, one man out. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Pitch on the way.
Don't catch off the plate. Don't do.
Hey. Four-seam meter right down the middle. I would have thought he popped a clutch on that pitch.
Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone.
Batting third. The third baseman.
Next, it'll be Brian Anderson. His past line against Aaron Nola. He carries with him a .448 batting average. Seven strikeouts on the stat sheet as well. Off the fastball here in a good spot, but ruled the ball 1-0. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. Just getting started here in Philly. A ball and two strikes to count now with the bases empty and two away. Taken off the outside as the breaking ball couldn't catch the corner. 2-2 count. Here it comes. Straight three balls as he can't get the bat off his shoulders. Side retired. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. So now the Phillies offense will see what they can do. No score. Sandy Alcantara gets the ball for Miami in this one. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has? That gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties. And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
And now, Alec Bohm. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Leading up for the Phillies, the third baseman, Alec Bohm.
Here's the pitch. And here's a slider that's nowhere close, and it's 1-0. Guys, this Marlins ball club, as they begin play here tonight, they dropped another one last time out, and in fact, they've won just twice in their last 8 tries.
Yeah, guys, dropping yesterday was a heartbreaker, without question. But you know what? You find a way. You show up to the yard today, you get out of the cab, and you watch countless hours of video, and you try and formulate a game plan to get this back to 500. 1-1 to start the road trip, and you're moving in the right direction.
A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. The count now at 2-2. Outside in a full count, 3-2.
See it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Full count still.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Lifted in the air to center field. Lede is right there, one down.
Batting second.
A look at the Phillies' batting order in this one. Who's the one to watch, Dan?
Well, Matt, I appreciate the way Bryce Harper plays the game. He's really had a heck of a year in the power categories, slugging over 500 coming into this one. That means almost every time he's hitting the ball, he's hitting it hard somewhere. Should be fun to watch.
And that'll bring up Gene Segura. As with one away, he can't make contact on the first pitch. It's strike one. 281, the average entering play. 8 home runs and 36 RBIs. Now here's the pitch. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Fouled away. Ball two with a sinker that runs off the inside. One out, nobody on. Did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay 2-2. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
One thing to take note of is how these last two batters have really driven up this pitch count. He's had to use 14 pitches already on them, and he's not even through this guy yet. 14 is near the top end of what you want to throw in a complete inning.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And missed with that one, it's ball four. A one-out walk here in the home first.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that with too much.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Lifetime against this particular arm. He has 7 hits in 23 at-bats. He's also been a strikeout victim 6 times. The 1-0 home misses for the second ball.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm and finding the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
Two-0 count. The pitch is in there for strike one. Segura leads off first with one away. Segura runs, which misses low. The throw down. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease.
So he swipes second successfully, but you have to wonder now if that might actually end up taking the bat out of the hands of one of their better hitters.
Well, that's a good point, Matt, but I'd be a little surprised if that's the case. It's still early and the game is tied, so that would be a pretty cautious move to pitch around him here or just walk him flat out.
Good call on that 3-1 sinker, and it's full now, 3-2. Away. One out and a runner on second base. Hit out towards second. Right to him. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Batting fourth, the first baseman, Reed Hoskins.
So a man at third here with two gone, and that'll bring up Rhys Hoskins. He's set and the pitch. This will take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0.
With the runner on third, two outs, base open, and a good hit at the plate, you have to be smart and not give in. If you walk this guy, so what? It's a lot worse if you give him a ball that he can hurt you on.
The set and the 1-0.
Hey, this guy's got an 89-mile-an-hour changeup. There was a time when 89 was a pretty good fastball.
Here's the 1-1.
Nope.
2-1.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane. You go to hit it in one position, and it's 6 to 8 inches dropping off the table and chasing your hand.
Men on third with two down. And he fouls this one off. Ready now, the payoff pitch. Fouled away. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 home. Sinker misses, ball four.
Some guys take a little time to find the zone, but with the second walk of the first inning, it might be a little more than just settling in here. Not sure how long of a leash they'll give him, but they're not going to let him walk the world out there.
So now to the plate, Didi Gregorius. As you get a look at his current righty-lefty splits entering play in this one. First offering on its way. Lays off, 1-0.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the corners if you're not throwing strikes consistently.
Downstairs, two balls and no strikes.
2-0 count, runners at the corners. You can bet he's looking for something to drive right here. There's a good chance he gets something to hit, too.
Runners on first and third, two away. Into the corner and slicing foul. Two and one, here it is. Strike swinging, timing a little off on that one.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Counts even at two. The pitch. Behind the plate, and they're going to get out of danger here as the strikeout will end the inning. A couple of walks, but no damage. We're back in Philadelphia right after this. So here's the cleanup hitter, Adam Duvall. His past line against Aaron Nola. He carries a 308 batting average. He's taken him deep once. First pitch of the AB now. Fouled off. Outside for a ball, one and one. And there are the umpires assigned to this one. Calling balls and strikes is Mr. Carl Dixon.
Dan, this is an offensive player's dream to have Carl Dixon behind the dish. He is tight on the corners.
He is, D-Row. And listen, he makes you bring the ball into the strike zone. Normally, high scoring of games when Carl's behind the dish.
Ball taken there. Two and one now. At the knees for a called strike, and it's back to even at two and two. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first down.
My man on the mound has just got great strikeout stuff working for him these days. Looking back at his last start, he racked up 9 Ks. And now he's looking like he can put up similar numbers in this one.
That'll bring in Garrett Cooper. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He enters play with 14 home runs to his credit this year.
That's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
Will be J.J. Blade. Base hit, line drive into the corner.
Take a look at this again in slow motion. He tracks this thing all the way, gets his hands quickly through the zone, and just rips it down the left field line, just how they draw it up.
Standing in now, Isan Diaz. As he'll take a changeup here for strike one. He'll enter play here with that average down in the low 200s. 6 home runs and 22 RBIs. Here comes the 0-1. Sinker, one ball, one strike. His past line against Aaron Nola. He's only 2 for 10. Now this is on the ground at first. We'll see if they can get two. Oh, he has some trouble with it. Only play will be to the pitcher covering, and the runners are able to move up.
Batting it, the catcher, number 28, Pedro Severino.
Pedro Severino digs in at the plate. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. Thank you. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Comes set. The 0-1.
On 0-2 here, he doesn't have to get in with a great pitch to hit. He's got a base open, so he has to focus on making a good pitch right here.
No balls, two strikes. Lifted down the line and left. Left fielder giving chase. He's got it, and they get out of the jam unscathed. Marlins strand a pair. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Second set to go. And next will be the speedy catcher, JT Realmuto.
JT Realmuto.
Here it comes. First pitch fastball in there for a called strike. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Boy, D'Lo, the game of baseball has changed. There's so much velocity in the game. That was a 96-mile-an-hour fastball that he smoked the other way.
Yeah, you have to keep your front shoulder tucked right there. You have to honor. When a guy's throwing that hard, 96 miles an hour, you have to honor that fastball and try and work it the other way to keep you on the off-speed.
So now to the plate, Roman Quinn. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Lede will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
Batting
all right, here's the defensive alignment for the Miami Marlins. And let's take a look at Brian Anderson. This guy, when I see him out there on the field, I think of one thing. He's a ball player. Offers versatility for his manager. Outfield, little third base. He was fighting for the 2018 Rookie of the Year.
So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen, as he'll take a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1. From the stretch.
1-1.
Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire. Ball two. Fastball just inside.
We all know this guy is a great hitter. In a 3-1 count, this is just what he's looking for. He loves to hit when the count's in his favor like this.
Realmuto's running high in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder, and he makes the catch in the corner.
Batting ninth, the pitcher, Aaron Nola.
Next up, Aaron Nola. From the stretch, as he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. Looks at a sinker there that drops in 1-1.
Hey, I don't mind that batter taking that strike right there. He's walked a couple people early in this game. Got to find out if he can find the zone. If he wants to walk them all in, we'll take it.
Realmuto is off of first with two away. Soft grounder left side. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are tied 0-0. Top of the third set to get underway, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Sandy Alcantara.
22, Sandy Alcantara.
First pitch on its way. Holds up here, but the pitch is a cold strike anyway.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
The batter.
Back to the top of the Miami baseman. Lineup now and stepping in, John Birdie. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the one placement.
Changeup too low, and it's 1-0. Ball two now. 2-0 count. Here it comes. Swung on and missed his fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right?
Up next,
all
DeMarlin.
He wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game,
Dickerson.
Which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, can't get on first base if you strike out.
At the plate, Corey Dickerson. Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. Sent on the ground out to second. Segura fields it cleanly. Whip this one first in time, and that ends the inning. Miami down in order. Home half of the third coming up. No score. That brings up Alec Bohm. 0-1 for him here in this one.
The third baseman, Alec. Oh.
50th pitch of the game on its way.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
A ball and a strike to the Phillies leadoff man. This one's down to third. And one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away.
The batter, number two, second baseman, Gene Segura.
Gene Segura standing in. And now the first pitch.
0-1. Counts 1-0.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. Oh, and you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
This is why it's so hard to be successful
right
as a hitter.
Number
when
three.
You fall behind in the count. Right. 1-2, you're probably expecting Harper. Some sort of off-speed pitches. But when the pitcher offers up a good, hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
Here's Bryce Harper now. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Harper from behind with an 0-2 count now.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
A windup and the 0-2 pitch.
One ball,
two out, nobody on. And it's fouled away. Here's another 1-2. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
And he'll take a look at ball one. Change up low, 2-0.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
2 balls and a strike.
I mean, he had to. I'm going to give him benefit of the doubt and say he was sitting something off speed. Because to be late on a fastball in a count like that is just unforgivable.
Now the 2-1.
Count it 3-1.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little
bit. Duvall.
So here's the cleanup hitter for Miami. Adam Duvall struck out in his first at-bat. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And this one gets away. Forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, now might be a good time to make a visit to the mound. Your pitcher walks the first batter and allows him to get into scoring position with the wild pitch. Got to settle him down and make sure everything's all right physically.
That evens it up 1-1. Now the pitch. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Anderson leads off second with nobody out. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here. Here's the 2-2. Popped up. Hoskins in foul ground. One down.
Now batting the first baseman, Garrett Cooper.
Next, here is Garrett Cooper. Now here's the first offering. This is line to left. Quinn is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Into the box, J.J. Blade. He looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. A base hit in his first trip. The the set and the 1-0. Short, hit hard. Gregorius has it. For the first with time to spare, and the side is retired. Marlins lead one. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning.
Ready to go.
And next
for the
Phillies, the imposing power bat, Reese Hoskins.
Reese Hoskins.
And now the first pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Lede is right there, and it's a very quick out number one.
Now batting, the shortstop, Didi Gregorius.
So bases are empty with one gone, and that'll bring up Didi Gregorius. Here's the first pitch. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. So first again, already two away here in the home court.
Now batting, catcher, JT Realmuto.
Next to hit is JT Realmuto, who collected a base hit his first time up.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. But pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot.
1-0 the count. Now here's the pitch. Fastball, and that thing got up there at 95 miles an hour, a ball and a strike. Two balls and a strike.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
The 2-1. It's looked at for ball three.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. Phillies down in order. Through four, still tied, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Don Mattingly about the Marlins' offensive production, and he really emphasized that they're not doing a very good job capitalizing on run-scoring opportunities. They've had their opportunities with runners in scoring position, but still have zero hits to show for it in those situations. He said repeatedly not coming through with a big hit can wear on you as a team, but in this sport, you have to dwell on the positives. He's confident they'll find a way to break through sooner or later.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. And now a pitch on the way. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on, and if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or the strikeout, and there's one gone.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
In now, Pedro Severino. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Wind up and the 0-1. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And they'll squeeze this one for the second out.
The pitcher, number 22, Sandy Alcantara.
Now it'll be Sandy Alcantara. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. And Dan, that's a pretty good example of why he's such a great pitcher.
Yeah, stuff. Stuff is obviously the important key to being dominant on the mound, but it doesn't mean a whole lot if you don't have outstanding control to go along with it. But he does, and he really spotted that pitch.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Hey, this is an amazing inning right here. Attacking the zone, keeping his defense invested. Chance to get off the field super quick.
The next 0-2. Swing and a liner. And that'll get down for a two-out single.
They keep the inning alive with a base hit, but you can see that's only the third hit. He's given up the entire game, so he's still in total control out there.
Stepping in now, John Birdie, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. The 1-0.
Aye. One ball, one strike.
A ball and two strikes now.
That's count 1-2. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Joe Girardi during the commercial break about the Phillies' offense, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Despite the fact that they've yet to push a run across, the game is still tied, and the pitch count for their opposition is really getting up there. They think that making him work as hard as he has is going to pay off later in the game, and that they just need to stick to the process.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks.
Leading up for the Phillies.
Now to bat, Roman Quinn comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame.
Quinn.
Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one.
Hey, I hope that call doesn't throw him off his game right here. He's been pitching one heck of a game, and I'd hate to see the umpire get in his head right now.
Hit softly down the line at first, but a foul ball, 1-1. Now here it comes. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Some activity out in the bullpen now as a couple of left-handers begin to stir. Two and two the count. Into the windup and the pitch. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. On deck, there's Andrew McCutchen. He'll hit next. Lifted down the line and left. And it's a foul ball. And this ball is popped up, drifting back behind the mound. Birdie is there, and there's one away.
Now batting, the center fielder, Andrew McCutchen.
So bases are empty with one out now, and that'll bring up the former National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. First offering. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Grounded to first. And taken to the bag himself for the out.
Now batting, the pitcher, Aaron Nola.
Next up will be the Phillies pitcher, Aaron Nola. Two away in the inning, and Dan, it looks like this could be another 1-2-3 inning for him.
Yeah, he has really found a groove on the mound, and it's been impressive to watch. It'll be interesting to see how long he can keep this dominance up.
First offering on its way.
1-0.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter-friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Now the 1-0.
Great job by the pitcher right there, changing eye levels. We all know he's a sinker ball pitcher, but if he could throw some four-seamers up in the zone like that, it could work for him.
Lays off the slider that time, 2-1.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
Looks like he swung it underwater that time for strike two. No runs, just one hit, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Fastball is outside, and it's full now, 3-2.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat, as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
The 3-2 pitch. Now here's a check swing, and they appeal down to first. No swing, so that's ball four.
Up next for Philadelphia.
He almost got him to commit there as we take another look at it in slow motion.
Whoa.
He comes awfully close to breaking that plane, but he was able to hold back. Strong wrist, and he gets a trip to first because of it.
At the plate now, Alec Bohm, as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Comes the 0-1. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline.
He wants that changeup back right there. Great arm action on that changeup. Hitter was just a smidge out in front.
Grounded slowly to the left side. Throw in time, and the side is retired. One left for Philadelphia. Sixth inning coming up. Still zip, zip. Stepping in once again is Corey Dickerson. He's tasked with starting the Marlins' sixth.
Corey Dickerson.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Line drive, base hit to right.
Dan, that can't bother you too much as a pitcher. Guy swinging first pitch.
Now,
one of the things you want to do, D-Rose, you have to try to get ahead with the first pitch. You want to throw one of the first two pitches for strikes. Unfortunately, sometimes when you bring the ball in the strike zone, you're bound to give up some base hits, but hopefully he can minimize the damage here.
Into the box now, Brian Anderson. Yes, he'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. No runs, four hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. And it's quickly 0-2. happened to send him packing. Pitch on its way.
One ball.
A breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. And that's into the gap and should be extra bases. Dickerson rounds third and is digging for the plate. And he's safe at the plate as they take the lead.
Finally, someone's able to scratch a run across. The pitching has been so dominant in this one. Let's see if this opens the floodgates a little bit.
Standing in now, Adam Duvall. As he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. No hits to this point. That one yanked just foul. A runner at second, nobody out. Again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now. Him up. Real Muto is there. One out.
Now batting, the first baseman, Garrett Cooper.
Up next, Garrett Cooper, 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Now here's the first offering.
From an offensive standpoint, this is where you got to push the throttle right here. You've had a couple hits in the inning. You've got a 1-0 count leverage. Let's see if he can gap some.
Whoa, right there.
Change up low, 2-0. Too far out in front that time. You can't keep it fair, 2-1. From the belt, the pitch. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
That was a good job tying him up inside on that strikeout
the
pitch. It wasn't even in the strike zone, but with the hitter protecting with two strikes, that's the kind of pitch you can get him to offer at, and he's probably not going to do much with it when he does make contact.
Into the box, J.J. Blade. Swing and a liner. That's in there. Base hit, Anderson. Blows through the stop sign, headed for home, and he's out. Beautiful throw home to cut down the run. A great throw from the outfield to cut down the run and end the inning. Certainly worth another look. More from Citizens Bank Park in just a moment. So now into the box is Gene Segura to start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
Yeah, I think if I'm the hitting coach right here, Maddie, I'm telling the offense to get aggressive. Just seems like we've been going too deep in counts, and this guy has got exploding stuff on the mound. So I would tell them get overly aggressive on a heater in the middle of the plate early.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch.
Count 1-0.
And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Swung on and missed. 1-1.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something
clean. Throw on the first, in time, one away. So one gone now as we give you a look at where these two teams find themselves entering play in the National League's Eastern Division race. So one gone in the inning now, and that will bring in the right fielder, Bryce Harper. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
And that's into the corner, a foul ball in right.
Huge swing of the bat right there, just hooking foul. Would have tied the game. I know there's still a lot of game left, but that was potentially a huge momentum swing there. Going to have to find a way to refocus and continue this at bat.
Here comes the 1-2.
Four foul balls in this AB. Pitcher cannot find anywhere to go to put this guy away.
He'll try again, 1-2. Hit down the line at first. This is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. But look out. Hot shot to third, and there are two away.
Now batting, first baseman, Reese Hoskins.
And that will bring up the Sacramento product, Reese Hoskins. Flew out last time up.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
The 1-0. Fastball down below the knees.
Well, this is a spot you'd like to be in. 2-0, good hitter. He's going to turn it loose right here.
A strike, and it's 2-1.
I can't imagine that pitcher was trying to put it right over the heart of the plate. Thank God he took that pitch right there. He'd be getting one back from the umpire.
3-1 to him now. That is in there at the letters to run it full, 3-2. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, you never want to issue a free pass to help it. But when a hitter like that digs in, you'd rather he's standing at first than driving a ball out of here and erasing your one-run lead.
Now the Marlins skipper's up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And we're going to see a pitching change, as that's going to do it for his starter here tonight. So he'll depart with the lead and a chance to be the winner, but he is responsible for the tying run at first. Now Ross Detweiler takes over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning.
Ross Detweiler.
Gregorius will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. He's ready. Now the pitch. And he fouls this one off.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Set to deliver the 0-1.
and he pops him up, drifting toward the left side of the infield. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Phillies strand one. They still trail 1-0. So now to the plate, Eason Diaz. He'll begin things here against Aaron Nola.
Eason Diaz.
First pitch on its way. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one. Fouled away. One is in there for the second strike.
You could tell this guy's got great feel for all this stuff right now. To break out that nasty hammer right there, this guy's on point.
He's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
Nice job there taking care of the leadoff hitter via the strikeout. I'll tell you, in a one-run game, especially this late, getting that first guy in the inning is so important. It changes the whole complexion of the inning, so that was a big out.
So now to the plate, Pedro Severino. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. 0-2 for him to this point. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0.
He hasn't thrown that pitch much all game. I got to believe as an offense, you just got to throw that pitch away and move on to the next one.
Bases are empty, one man out. I changed things up on him and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Now the pitch. And a sinker ditched below there. Into the dirt, in fact.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
To give, here's the payoff pitch, and this misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work.
Well, when you've been out there as long as he has, you have to expect to lose a little precision in your location. He's up over 90 pitches now, so he might be starting to tire a little bit. Something to keep an eye on.
Your Connor Scott will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 81, Connor Scott.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Now the 0-1.
Count 1-1.
And a change up here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Changeup, called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2. Runners on first with one down. Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone.
Anytime you get rookies just breaking into the big leagues, you have to expect a certain amount of this. There aren't any easy at-bats at this level, and you really have to learn how to slow the game down in your head because everything feels like it's so much faster up here.
To the plate now, John Birdie, as he'll take a look at a sinker here, too low for ball one.
1-0. Is looked at for the first strike. Next pitch will be number 100 for him now through 6 2/3.
Yeah, he's grinded this one out, and he's got a chance to get through 7 strong innings, Dan. That's got to light the bullpen up.
Yeah, and it does.
And what an effort on the running play to end the inning. The Marlins lead 1, but they're up 1-0. Johnny Curtis will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the 7th.
For the Marlins, number 39, John Curtis.
Last half of the 7th here, and in steps the catcher, JT Realmuto.
The catcher, JT Realmuto.
First delivery to him.
0-1's the count.
Here's the pitch. High in the air out towards shallow right. Duvall has the best view of this one, so he'll take it for the first down.
The left fielder, number 24, Roman Quinn.
So next to the plate for the Phils, Roman Quinn, 0-2 from him so far in this one. First offering on its way. Tries to bunt his way on here, but this is a foul ball. And the pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number 2.
Well, this has been a completely different performance from the offense that we saw yesterday. Now they were looking like the 27 Yankees 24 hours ago, but they've been held in check so far in this one. That's kind of how baseball goes, though.
Here's Andrew McCutchen now. He'll take one on the inside corner at the knees at strike 1. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. A 1 pitch on its way. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Stays alive, still 0-2. Nothing in 2 count, and the pitch. And no problem over there at first as he flags this one down to end the inning. 3 up, 3 down for Philadelphia. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Joe Girardi is going to get up off the dugout bench and confer at home plate, so we'll likely see a double switch here. Archie Bradley will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the 8th spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Adam Haseley will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Now at the plate, Corey Dickerson is working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
Corey Dickerson.
First offering. Now a left-hander up and throwing in that Philly bullpen. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Drilled on the ground to short. Gregorius is there. throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight.
Now batting.
So his day fully over now as you get a look at the pitching line for the Philly starter. He was on point from the get-go this evening.
Hey, Matty V, this guy had it going in this one. Look down at the bottom of that skull. 10 strikeouts. He hit that swing and miss stuff from the beginning all the way to the end in this one.
Stepping in now, Brian Anderson, as he would look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He's 1-for-2 in this one. The 1-0. And he misses 2-1. One out, nobody on. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss.
You know, from a hitter's perspective, you get pounded in, and then he throws a nasty changeup away. Is the mindset to tell yourself that he's going to go in and out all day long, or is he going to double up? That's the cat and mouse we're seeing right now.
He stays alive, still 2-2.
It's going to be back to some serious teamwork if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
The 2-2 one more time. Swing and a liner. That's in for a base hit, and he's 2-for-3.
The right fielder, number 14, Adam Duvall.
Into the box now, Adam Duvall, as he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. The 1-0.
Clearly working the bottom of the zone, trying to get a ground ball for a double play.
The 2-0 on the way. Aye. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. From the stretch.
That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with 3 quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. The 0-1. And this is hit hard to the right side. But this will wind up a foul ball, strike 2. 2 out with the man at first. And this one's in the dirt. Good job there as the count goes to 1-2. Still a ball and 2 strikes. Here he comes again, 1-2.
2 balls, 2 strikes. We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
This is on the ground over first. Dive, and he knocks it down. But they'll still manage to get the out on the force, and with that fine play, the inning comes to an end. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and 1 man left aboard. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. Miami's out in front, 1-0.
Your
Edie Garcia
please.
Is on to pitch out now of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th.
Number 93, Jimmy Garcia.
Here now is Adam Haseley. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago.
Haseley.
Now here it comes. And they start him out away with a called strike. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Lede has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first down.
Now batting, third baseman, Alex Bohm.
So the Phillies batting order turns over and set to go. Alex Bohm, in his career against this pitcher, not a big sample size, 0 for 1. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Ready with the 0-1.
One ball, one strike.
A curveball that kind of backed up on him right there. Might have popped out of his hand just a little bit earlier than he intended.
One home. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. Bases are empty, one man out. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Rounded up the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Now the pitch. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Boy, he's having a hard time just putting the ball in play right now.
The batter,
he took a hat trick with three strikeouts yesterday, and here's another one today. Looks to me like he just needs to simplify his approach and focus on making some contact.
At the plate now, Gene Segura. And the first pitch misses to him. It's ball one. No hits to this point. The 1-0.
Ball, that's upstairs. Outside, that's the ball.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Two out, nobody on. There's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Full count now. Now the 3-2 pitch. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And a fastball is hit on the ground towards short. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Phillies down in order. It remains 1-0.
Home
Jose Alvarado. Enters from Japan to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth.
Jose Alvarado.
Now to the plate, J.J. Bleday. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
J.J. Bleday.
First pitch of the A.B. now. Off we go in the ninth as the first pitch misses for ball one.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
Fouled off. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Now a ball lying toward the gap in left center. And there's a base hit. And this could wind up as an important insurance strike here as the leadoff man's aboard to start the ninth.
Well, talk about having a pretty special game. That's his third single of the game, D-Row. 3-for-4. Not a bad game.
Yeah, just not trying to do too much, Dan. Taking what the pitcher's giving him right here. If the fastball's away, shooting it the other way. If he's got something hanging in the middle of the plate, turning and burning a little bit. Nice execution.
Nope.
Isan Diaz is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. The 1-0. A ball and a strike now. Nobody out, runner on first. Breaking ball snaps in there for a called strike two.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him.
Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
That's the third time in this game he's gone down on strikes. Severino. Not the game he was hoping to have when he was taking batting practice, but at least his guys are ahead.
In now, Pedro Severino. All over that one, but a little out in front. Foul ball. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Ball bounces and this one gets away. And you can forget about the double play now as the runner moves up to second base.
Well, when you throw a breaking ball in the dirt, that's the danger. You have to trust your catcher, but this one skips away and the open base takes the double opportunity away with it. Might prove to be costly.
In there, 1-2 now.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Count even at 2-2 to the Marlins catcher. Hit sharply on the ground. Taken in by Gregorius. In time to first, and there are two away.
Up next for the Marlins, the pitcher.
Magnera Sierra will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 34, Magnera Sierra.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing in one. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. The 0-1 offering. Swing and a miss here, and he's behind in the count now, 0-2.
The count doesn't mean much to this batter. He's all in. He's not concerned with striking out, so he's going to get his A swing off.
Nope.
Can't quite get the low outside corner there. It's 1-2.
He didn't look overly fooled right there because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but
He certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
Ready with the 1-2.
Nope. That's inside.
Enters the game to now finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth.
Number 36, Dylan.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And that will bring up Bryce Harper.
For the Phillies, the right fielder. Right.
First offering on its way.
Harper.
Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. Leap, but it's off his glove. Stay in the park as it's off the center field wall. He's safe at the plate. And we are tied here in the bottom of the ninth.
Number 17.
Next to bat will be Reese Hoskins.
Hoskins.
And so watch a sinker here that misses its ball one. It was a walk in his last trip. And the 1-0 pitch. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike. Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. Bases are empty here, nobody out. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Good slider there, but laid off and called the ball low. This is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Now the 3-2 pitch. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential winning run is aboard at first.
Well, it's obvious that earlier home run gave up and still on his mind. He had him 3-2, but he didn't want to give him anything over the heart to play the hit. So we'll see if that walk comes back to hurt him.
Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first. And that'll be a wise decision as he's a potential go-ahead run. Here's the first pitch.
1-0.
Possible winning run aboard here. Nobody out. And 2-0 now as this misses below the knees.
You never want to fall behind as a pitcher, but doing it to a guy like this is even worse. He's got to bear down and execute for the rest of this at-bat starting right now.
Runners off for second. Pitch outside. The throw. Not in time as he steals second.
If you can't trust the reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
So here is JT Realmuto. Lifetime versus this arm. He's a 333 hitter. Here's the first pitch.
Off the plate, ball.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Possible winning run on second. No one out. This ball will be chopped. Fired.
and two. I always remember John Smoltz telling me the greatest asset a closer can have is short-term memory. And this situation calls for it right here. He's got to forget that he has any traffic on the base pass and just attack the zone.
Now the 1-2 pitch. Here's a fly ball well hit. Center fielder on the run. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. And he'll indeed move up 90 feet, putting runners at the corners now with one
now
away.
Good read there at second base to know he can make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
Next to stand in is Roman Quinn. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
Here's the first pitch. And the runner's coming home. Now he's bunting here to win the game, and he gets it down. And how do you like that? They roll the dice, the squeeze works, and it's going to end the ball game.
What? What did I just see? My eyes have to be messing with me because I think I just saw a walk-off suicide squeeze to end this thing. Gutsy call or stupid, I'm not sure, but it sure looks like a genius move right now. Incredible.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The Phils get their 20th home win this year. Jose Alvarado earns his third win of the year in relief. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Final line score.